everyone. Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine at the Marriott Marina, downtown San Diego. This particular vessel is a 2020 Jeanneau 490 performance version. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular yacht has to offer.
All right, so this is the 2020 Jeanneau 490 Sun Odyssey. This particular vessel is a Philippe Rion hull design. This is one of his latest hulls, and it is absolutely innovative. We have a hard chine starting from the bow, carrying all the way to the aft of the vessel. Large side hull ports, really innovative design and look, all flush hatches. One thing I'm gonna talk about is a lot of the rigging aspects of it. When we get up to the deck, we have split shrouds, so it's easy for you to walk up to the foredeck. Large Genoa tracks on the side deck. Beautiful Dodger connector and bimini. On top of the bimini is a solar panel that's been wrapped in a carbon fiber wrap, so you can't even tell that it's on there. Again, the performance version really stands out. The hull design stands out. The twin rudders gives it great stability, great handling characteristics, and really phenomenal performance. Here at the transom, we have the drop-down swim platform. This is operated by a push button or a electric remote control. We have a life raft storage locker and then a locker here that is designated fully sealed off here. This is where a generator could stow if so desired. The current owners keep a dinghy down below. Hot and cold swim step shower. They've done, again, really nice job on the install. This is the webbing that they've done to hide all of the electrical cables that are connected to the solar panels just above the bimini, as you can see there. All right, as we step into the cockpit, you're gonna notice this is one massive cockpit for a 49-foot yacht. I've kind of brought half of it down here so you can kind of see with the filler cushion in it. Both of the backrests actually will fold out and lay flat. So you'll see that from some of the pictures that I have. Since we're right here, centrally located is our platform up and down switches, and then our lighting controls. We also have our autopilot, and then our compass cup holders, built-in stainless steel grab handle, and then in the cockpit table that has two leaves that open up on both sides, lots of storage. Off to the starboard side of the vessel, we have cockpit speakers, our two-speed Harkin winches, and then our jammer clutches for the main sheet and Genoa sheet that are led there. You're also gonna see an eyelet down below there, and then there's a block outboard to that lower lifeline. That's where the Code Zero sheets come right into as well too. Hydraulic backstay, we have cockpit cushions with custom rail backs cushions as well too, that's nice. A composite steering wheel. And so when you're here at the helm itself, you have access to our one of two Raymarine hybrid touchscreen GPS displays, our windlass chain counter, our VHF, our bow thruster, and our throttle control. Just across from the starboard helm, you can see this is a nice angled display here. This will actually show us our engine RPMs. We only have 154.9 engine hours on the Yanmar, so very, very low hours on it. And then again, when you're here at the helm, sitting down, helm at the, hand at the helm, you have a really nice sight line looking up forward. This is a comfortable boat, a very easy boat to single hand and shorthand sail. Since I'm here, I'm just gonna walk you up. This is the nice thing about the new walk-around decks. Again, the Dodger itself has built-in stainless steel grab handles. This is the Macrolon glass, a removable connector, and then our two solar panels that are mounted above the bimini. There's also windows above the bimini as well too, so you can actually see your mainsail. As I mentioned, flush hatches everywhere. And what I love about this design is that the gooseneck is brought down really far low. So when you're standing up here, you actually can get access to the top of your stack pack here. So these are upgraded performance sails as well too. And then as we move up forward, you're gonna see, again, lots of real estate here on the foredeck. And we also have a sail locker. Inside of the sail locker is our Code Zero. So this opens up three latches here. There's also a built-in lock. And then our Code Zero is in that bag right there. So that just gets hoisted up and then attached to the bowsprit here. And you can see we also have a double purchase for the spinnaker halyard. So that gives you all the tension you need to fly a code zero or asymmetrical, and then another tack attachment point. Delta style anchor coming back to the quick windlass. And then the anchor locker accessibility is right here from the top. And you have a second control here as well. So it's chain and rode down below there. LED navigation lights. And then again, just looking at this deck, very, very clean deck. Double spreader mast. Up on the mast, we have deck light, steaming light. We have our radar. And then at the top, wind point, wind speed, VHF, and wind direction. Looking back aft, we have the second, halyard here with, again, double purchase system on that. So in the performance package, we get custom sails, taller mast, we get diform standing rigging. Again, that's with the flat edges on the standing rigging, Dyneema running rigging, and just really sets it off from the else, giving you that performance that you're looking for. And again, with ease of sailing and a classic mainsail mast, most of the time people are worried about, you know, stacking it up and closing it. But now with this system, it just drops into the bag and it can easily be accessible here. So it is really a nice advantage here. All right, working our way back aft. As I mentioned, this backrest also lays out flat. So you have two very large lounge areas as well too. We have our second hybrid touchscreen GPS plotter display here. And again, two-speed Harkin electric winches. And again, it's so easy to single hand this boat. You can hit the auto tack function, which is like either negative 10 and negative 1, or plus and plus, and it'll tack in that direction. And you can handle your sheets right here without even, virtually moving a footstep. So I really like the accessibility here. Phenomenal visibility. And again, the cockpit is really impressive with this drop down swim platform. All right, let's move up forward. Line bags off to the port side, electric cabin top winch off to the port side as well too. All of our sheets and halyards and the clutches are all properly labeled. And again, this is very, very lightly used. We're gonna come down below the vessel. We have four gradual steps. When we get down here, you have a nice span of the salon of the vessel. Our nav station is off to the port side. What I like about this nav station, it almost acts as like a second dinette as well. So you have seating here and then a forward-facing nav station. Beautiful interior woodwork, and it just has this nice leather accents as well too. So the nav station is quite nice, a large storage area down below that. 110 outlet with a little computer plug. We have a multi-repeater here, our inverter controllers, our Raymarine VHF, our multi-controllers that allows us to monitor our tanks. This particular vessel has one water tank and two fuel tanks. So I really like that option because you can always add a water maker, but you have the additional fuel, which is quite nice. Not only the additional fuel, but you have a large lithium battery bank for the house, and that's what the solar is also feeding. So the advantages of the lithium are much lighter, much higher amperage, and then you also are able to recharge at a much faster rate. So lots of advantages with the lithium and solar. We have our 12 volt display. So again, one push of a button, all of our electronics turn on or off, our lighting, our fusion stereo controller here. This is also Bluetooth, USB input, and then we have a nice little barometer and clock there. So great nav station, very, very clean, very accessible. Again, it's just a really nice layout here. We're gonna go to the aft cabin. Here in the aft cabin, we have three identical queen berths throughout this vessel. So before I get too far, look at this large windows, opening hatches, side hull port, another opening hatch here, large berth here. Underneath here, our battery switches are in our electric winch breakers. And then we have also access to the batteries underneath this berth. But again, really nice, area here. And then there's even an opening hatch all the way back there. Again, aviation style shades close this off. 110, two USB ports here. Nice large opening hanging locker. And then again, we have shelving throughout this area as well too. engine access from both starboard and port side and from under the companionway steps. There's also zero sills, steps. So, no door sills. It's all flat, one level across the boat. So really impressive on that regards. Opening hatches, everywhere you go with lots of storage throughout the yacht. This is quite impressive. And then again, as I mentioned, the companionway steps open up and we gain access to our engine. And virtually you could eat off this engine with that low of hours on it. It's barely getting broken into. We have our primary fuel pump right here filter with a little hand pump on the top of it as well too. So you can prime it if so desired. And then, your secondary fuel filter, our sea strainers in the back there, which is accessible. Really nice engine sound shield as well too. Directly across from us, we have a cabinet here with additional storage. So again, lots of storage here for all your goodies. And then our dayhead access. The dayhead access is quite nice because you walk right into the electric Jabsco quiet flush toilet and then a separate shower sink compartment. And then again, there is an opening hatch here. They've frosted the windows over for privacy, and you have access into the aft cabin from this as well too. So whoever gets this cabin has access into the dayhead compartment. But identical berth here, same with the storage, hanging locker space. And then this pole right here is a manual pole, and that is what allows you to toggle between either starboard or port fuel tank. So that is a nice upgrade option there too. Access, this little cabinet pops right off and you have access to your sea strainer right there, side of the engine. And again, zero door sills on the main level. You do have one here because it is the head compartment. So they kind of want to break that off, but really nice and easy to walk around. Also notice the attention to detail, all hardwood hardware here. We have this leather inlaid, also matches the stainless steel grab handles with the leather wrap on this. We have this beautiful U-shaped salon seating around the salon table that will actually drop down, turn into a berth. This center little island bench will scoot back and in if so desired. We have access to our bilge there. Down below here, this opens up and we have access to a wine locker. So it's a great use of space there as well too. And then now coming into the galley compartment, this is really impressive. It's center line, so it's at the best point of the vessel underway. We have a large opening drawer here with there's our trash can, and then we have additional cup storage, silverware utensil storage. Underneath the sink is lots of storage. Double stainless steel sinks. We have a top loading and side loading access to the refrigerator, a small freezer compartment there as well too. Three burner stove and oven, and then we also have the pop-up microwave here, and so that just pops up when in use, puts back down, closes off, so you get that countertop space when not in use, and it's a really clever design. And then we have our freezer here, which you can also adjust the temperature to make this an additional fridge if so desired. So really a nice layout in how they've done everything. Underneath here is additional cabinet space as well too. Not to mention you have storage in this seating and all around underneath the seating cushions as well. Underneath this cabinet, this opens up as a nice drawer. So that's a really nice additional storage there. And then it just goes on and on. But look at this. I mean, there's just storage here for wine bottles, additional storage around 110, 12-volt outlets, Bose speakers that are tied into the Fusion stereo system. Lots of natural light. Lots of opening hatches as well too. So this vessel gets lots of just good air ventilation. As we move up forward, you can see the beautiful bulkheads that they have here. So it's more of a fabric type bulkhead. And then it goes into this accordion here with the, solid wood trims. Walking up to the forward master, this is really impressive. So there's a lot of stuff to kind of go over here. But before we get too far, I'm gonna close the door and then I'm gonna open up this door right here. This is a separate sink. We have a little mirror here, and then you have your electric quiet flush Jabsco toilet here, overhead opening hatch. And then we move up forward, a little tray area. This is all storage underneath the bed here. And then this opens up You have a large hanging locker shelving. Again, just really nicely done. I love the angles and the curves that they've incorporated into this. 110 12 volt outlets. You have reading lights, both headboards, light switches. And then again, with that mirror, it really just carries this out, making it feel very, very large, which it is. Two overhead opening hatches. And then when you're looking aft, you can see this nice, large, really classy kind of bookshelving case right here. And then storage all below that. Additional storage hanging locker space here. And then this is really just clever. This opens up and you have all of this shelving as well too. So they've done a great job of shelving. And now we're kind of into the kind of a full length mirror, vanity, second sink here. We have 110 outlet, a nice hole port so you can sit there and look out while you're here. And then just behind me is a full walk-in shower. So really clever design, two overhead opening hatches as well too, but I love how they separated the shower compartment from the head compartment. So again, really clever, really just a great design, gives you so much function here in the master cabin. Now we're working our way back aft, just in the hallway here, overhead opening hatch, and now we're coming back looking aft into the salon of the Jeanneau 490 performance version. All right, so I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. There was a lot of stuff we covered in a short period of time. It's very rare to have a Jeanneau 490 Sun Odyssey performance version here on the West Coast. I believe this is one of two that were sold from the factory with the upgraded lithium batteries. And then again, we've done a lot of upgrades from the canvas to the solar and really making this the perfect West Coast offshore cruiser. If you're looking for something that's easy to handle, shorthanded or single-handed, and really want that nice performance, stability, and just a great platform for you, your family and friends to kind of hang out on or be on, this is a perfect vessel to look at. Feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this and see what's coming on the market before it even hits the market. Thank you again and bye for now.